فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، We are still in the explanation of the book مختصر في أصول العقائد الدينية, written by العلامة عبد الرحمن ابن ناصر السعدي رحمه الله. This is the second part بإذن الله الكريم. And we stopped at the second, the first asal we were still on. We were in the first asal, which is aslu tawheed, which he was speaking about. We spoke about uluhiyya, we spoke about al-rububiyya, and we're now going to go into tawheed al-asma'i wa-sifat. Naam.
ودخل في توحيد الأسماء والصفات إثبات جميع معاني الأسماء الحسنى لله تعالى الواردة في الكتاب والسنة.
So the Shaykh رحمه الله رحمة واسعة, here he speaks about something very important, which is that from the things that enter توحيد الأسماء والصفات, and that is إثبات to affirm جَمِيعِ مَعَانِ الْأَسْمَاءِ الْحُسْنَى, all of the meanings that are in Allah تبارك وتعالى's names, all of the meanings that are in these names, we affirm them. So we don't just believe that Allah's names are مجرد أعلام, they are just not mere names, rather they are names that have meanings in it, and those meanings that are in it, we affirm them. That's what the Shaykh رحمه الله here he's speaking about. But when we affirm these meaning, we affirm them without no kayfiyya. We don't attach or stipulate a kayfiyya to it. Because the how of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's characteristics is something our knowledge hasn't reached, or is something we don't know of. And we leave it with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the kayfiyya. But what we don't do is, because we do not know the kayfiyya, we don't distort the meaning that are in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's names. Rather, we affirm those meanings that are in it. Na'am.
وَالْإِيمَانُ بِهَا ثَلَاثُ دَرَجَاتٍ.
So the Shaykh here, rahimahullah, he is speaking about believing in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's names, believing in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's names and attributes are of three levels. ثَلَاثُ دَرَجَاتٍ, three levels. And these three levels are pillars. وَهِيَ أَرْكَانٍ. They are pillars in or for the person who is believing in Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's names and believing in Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's characteristics. And they are as follows. نعم.
إِمَانٌ بِالْأَسْمَاءِ.
So the first one is believing in the name that is a name of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. So we actually believe that this name is His, and that we don't negate it, the name. Because Allah said in the Quran, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَدُعُوهُ بِهَا. Verily Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has asma'ul husna. Allah has good names, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those good names, we supplicate to Him with it. So we affirm those names. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَدُعُوهُ بِهَا وَذَلُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ. And also there are the opposites, those who actually distort and negate Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's names. So the first one is al-imanu bil-ism al-ilahi. You actually believe that this name is from His names. And the names of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, that which we know of, are 99. But they are more than 99. Because the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith, what did he say to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in the supplication? What was the dua he said? اللهم إني أسألك بأسماء اللهم إني أسألك أو الله I ask you بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمت أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك. So there are names from Allah, there are names of Allah in which we have no knowledge of, in which Allah kept it in the unseen, and that we don't know of. But the ones we know of are 99 names, of His subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we affirm those 99 names. And as you're all aware of, the narration that mentions those 99 together is not authentic. It is not authentic. That says Allah's names are these 99 like that, in those order and in one narration. Rather, that's not right. But after looking at the Quran and the Sunnah, of course it comes to those 99 names of His subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, the second level or the second pillar is believing in the characteristics that this name carries. So there is a characteristics in the name. There's an attribute in this name. You have to affirm that there this characteristics that is in this name, you affirm it. As we said before, Allah's names are أَعْلَامٌ بِاعْتِبَارِ دَلَالَتِهَا عَلَى الذَّاتِ وَأَوْصَافٌ بِاعْتِبَارِ دَلَالَتِهَا عَلَى الْمَعَانِ. Allah's names are names, and they are also what? Attributes and characteristics that are in it. So we actually affirm those characteristics that are in those names. That's the second pillar. Now,
وَإِيمَانٌ بِأَحْكَامِ صِفَاتِهِ.
The third one is بِحُكْمِ الصِّفَة, believing in the ruling that are in these characteristics. And as we said, as we say all the time, is that the حكم الصِّفَةِ is فَإِنَّهُ يُطْلَقُ عَلَى مَعْنَيَيْنِ. It refers to two meanings, and it means two things. The first one is أَثَرُهَا النَّاشِئْ عَنْهَا, the effects that come out. So what is meant by حُكْمُ الصِّفَةِ, it means the effects that come out of this name. And what does it mean that the effect that come out of this name? It means that you know Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is one who has, for instance, let's take the name Al-Alim. The name Al-Alim is Ismu min Asma'illah. So if you look at the first pillar, it's an Ismu Ilahi. You affirm it as a name of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. The second thing is that you affirm as a characteristics that befits His Majesty Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And what's the characteristics that's in the name Al-Alim? Sifatul Ilm, the characteristics of knowledge. So you actually affirm it. And the third thing is, which is حكم الصفة. حكم الصفة would be what? If we said it's two. The first one, which is أثارها الناشئ عنها, that you know as an individual, and that you believe as an individual, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of everything which you do. Allah knows everything you're doing now. Allah knows everything you have done in the past. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what you're going to do in the future. Allah even knows what you haven't done if you were to do it the way you would have done it. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is what? أَثَرُهَا النَّاشِعُ عَنْهَا. You know the effects that this name has. The second one, which is النِّسْبَةُ بَيْنَ الصِّفَةِ وَمُتَعَلَّقِهَا. The relationship between the characteristics and the thing that it's attached to, which is the معلومات. You know the relationship with Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, His knowledge, and the relationship between the things that He knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, which are the معلومات. That's meant by the second meaning, which is النِّسْبَةُ بَيْنَ الصِّفَةِ وَمُتَعَلَّقِهَا. So those are the two meanings it has when we say حُكْمُ الصِّفَةِ, the rulings that are in the characteristics. نعم.
كَالْعِلْمِ بِأَنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ ذُو عِلْمٍ وَيَعْلَمُ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ ذُو قُدْرَةٍ وَيَقَدِيرُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ إلى آخر ما له من الأسماء المقدسة.
So the Shaykh here, رحمه الله رحمة واسعة, what he's given is an example of what he has said. The three, ثلاثة أركان, the ثلاث درجات. What he's trying to do is he's trying to give an example for it. For example, the name of Allah, which is Al-Alim, it's an ism, ismun ilahi, we affirm it for Allah تبارك وتعالى as a name of His. The second pillar would be what? الصفة, إثبات الصفة. الصفة الإلهية. You affirm these characteristics which is in it, which is صفة العلم. And the third one would be what? حكم الصفة, the ruling that are in these characteristics. And we said it's two. The first one is أثرها الناشئ عنها. And the second one was what? النسبة بين الصفة ومتعلقها. There's a thing that we have to point out here which the Shaykh رحمه الله has not spoken about. And that is, these three pillars are only referring to the characteristics which are what? متعدية, the transitive characteristics, and it's not referring to the characteristics which are intransitive characteristics. The characteristics that it's referring to is the characteristics which are transitive, sahih? The sifat which are mutaaddiya. As for the sifat which are lazima, characteristics which are intransitive, such as al-hay, the characteristics al-hay. These characteristics, the third pillar will not be present, which is حكم الصفة will not be present. The only thing you would have to come with, which is the only thing you have to come with, is الإيمان بالاسم الإلهي, and the second one is الإيمان بالصفة الإلهي. As for coming with what بحكم الصفة, then that's not in the صفات, the characteristics which are what, the characteristics which are لازمة. So the Shaykh Rahimahullah did not mention that, and so we just mentioned this as an important point. نعم.
ودخل في ذلك إثبات علوه على خلقه واستوائه على عرشه ونزوله كل ليلة إلى سماء الدنيا على الوجه اللائق بجلاله وعظمته.
The Shaykh Rahimahullah, he's now speaking about from the things that enter into believing and affirming Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's names and attributes. He says, إِثْبَاتُ, to affirm, عُلُوِّهِ, Allah is above, عَلَى خَلْقِهِ, His creation, وَاسْتِوَائِهِ, and that He's higher, عَلَى عَرْشِهِ, His throne. And the evidence for that is قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى الرَّحْمَانُ عَلَى الْعَرْشِ اسْتَوَى. Abu Aliyat al-Rayahi رحمه الله, he said, عَلَى وَارْتَفَعَ. الإمام البخاري in his kitab خلق أفعال العباد, خلق أفعال العباد, الإمام البخاري, he also brings a narration from Abdullah ibn Abbas that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is above his creation, rahimahullahu ta'ala. So the word wastiwa'ihi ala arshihi means ala wartafa, and it is not the meaning of the Jahmiyyah and the Asha'ira who say that the word istawa is istawla, and that is incorrect. And Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah refuted them in his kitab Al-Kafiyatu al-Shafiyah fi al-intisari lil-firqati al-najiyah. He says nunu jahmin, nunu al-yahudi walamu jahmin, huma fi wahyi rabbi zaidatani. The noon of the Jews, when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said to them qulu hitta, say hitta, and they said hinta, they added an extra noon. That's what the Jews have done. And then the Jahmiyyah came, and what they did was ar-Rahmanu 'ala al-'arshi istawa, they added an extra lam onto it. Ibn al-Qayyim says huma fi wahyi, they are both in the revelation of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, an additional adding, meaning they are not from the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So istiwa in the Arabic language is known as ulu, and that which is high. ولذلك, from the great noble scholars were asked, Al-Asma'i rahimahullah was asked about istiwa, has it come in any other meaning? And he rahimahullah mentions that it's only come in the meaning of ulu and irtifa', and no other meaning do the Arabs know as istiwa to mean istawla. وَنُزُولِهِ, that Allah تبارك وتعالى, he descends. So the ulu, we affirm it. And the ulu are three types: ulu qahrin, wa ulu qadrin, wa ulu dhatin. And whenever we find Allah تبارك وتعالى in the Quran affirming ulu for himself, we actually affirm all three for him. ولذلك, from the Ahlul Bid'ah, what they want to do is that they want to affirm part of what's in the meaning of al-ulu. One of the meanings that are in ulu is ulu qadrin and ulu qahrin. They want to affirm that, but they don't want to affirm ulu dhatin. When reality, ulu dhatin, is from those things which the ayah has mentioned or has affirmed. How is it that you're going to choose part of the meaning of ulu and leave off the other part? When the nusus has not restricted it to any of the meanings, then you have to leave it unrestricted. And when it's unrestricted, it falls on three meanings: ulu qahrin, wa ulu qadrin, and ulu dhatin. All three of them. So here the Shaykh rahimahullah, he's trying to affirm ulu dhatin. And that's the one that Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah are in discussion and debate with Ahlul Bid'ah. Because Ahlul Bid'ah, the one they don't want to affirm is that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He is above His creation, عُلُوُّ ذَاتٍ, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And as you can see, the Shaykh Rahimahullah, he says, عَلَى الْوَجْهِ اللَّائِقِ بِجَلَالِهِ. So he said, وَنُزُولِهِ كُلَّ لَيْلَةِ إِلَى سَمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He comes down the last third of the night. And He comes down to إِلَى سَمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. And this is ثَابِتٌ عَنْهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, that the Prophet صَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمُ عَلَيْهِ said this. وَلِذَلِكَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ إِبْنُ تَيْمِيَةَ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ, he authored a book on just this issue, حَدِيثُ النُّزُولِ, that Allah تبارك وتعالى descending, subhanahu wa ta'ala. How does Allah descend? How does Allah go above His throne? How is Allah above His creation? All of that we say, عَلَى الْوَجْهِ اللَّائِقِ بِجَلَالِهِ وَعَظَمَتِهِ. He does all of that, and He is those characteristics in a way that befits His Majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when a person affirms all of those characteristics, he has to affirm it to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, that it befits His Majesty in a way that that these characteristics, they are in accordance to His Majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as I mentioned yesterday, that the creation, they themselves, us as the creation, your own characteristics differ from stages to stages. Your hand when you were young, for instance, is not as it is right now. Your hand when you were young is not like it is right now. So how is it that the Khaliq and the Makhluq, their characteristics are the same? So this is affirming for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala naqs, deficiency. If you say Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and His creation are the same in characteristics, is as though you are affirming for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and naqs, deficiency, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Naam.
وَدَخَلَ فِي ذَلِكَ إِثْبَاتُ الصِّفَاتِ الذَّاتِيَةِ الَّتِي لَا يَنْفَكُّ عَنْهَا كَالسَّمْعِ وَالْبَصْرِ وَالْعِلْمِ وَالْعُلُوِّ وَنَحْوِهَا وَالصِّفَاتُ الْفِعْلِيَّةِ وَهِيَ الصِّفَاتُ الْمُتَعَلِّقَةُ بِمَشِيئَتِهِ وَقُدْرَتِهِ كَالْكَلَامِ وَالْخَلْقِ وَالرِّزْقِ وَالرَّحْمَةِ وَالْإِسْتِوَاءِ عَلَى الْعَرْشِ وَنُزُولِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا كَمَا يَشَاءُ.
The Shaykh Rahimahullah, he now goes into speaking about that which falls under believing in Allah's names and attributes. From the things that fall under believing in Allah's names and attributes is الصفات الذاتية والصفات الفعلية, knowing the difference between the two. الصفات الذاتية, as the Shaykh Rahimahullah mentions, هي الصفات الملازمة لذات الله. They are characteristics that are attached, that do not detach itself from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's essence, Allah's dhat subhanahu wa ta'ala. La fala tanfaku anhu abada. They do never, and in any way, form or shape, do they detach themselves from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, such as kal ilmi wal hayat. Allah is always one who has knowledge, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is one which is always alive subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Hajj, who's from the A'immatul Malikiyah rahimahullah, he gave also another perspective in how the sifat al-dhatiyah can be looked at. And la shaka, this observation of his is hasanun, is very good. And that is, the sifat al-dhatiyah are characteristics when you affirm it for Allah, you can't affirm the opposite for Him. La yusafu Allahu bimuqabiliha. The opposite cannot be affirmed for Him. For instance, sifatul ilm, knowledge, you affirm it for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, which is a sifat. Sifat dhatiyya. But you can't affirm for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala the opposite, وَهُوَ الْجَهْلُ, and that is ignorance. The same is sifatul hayat, that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is alive. And this is a sifat dhatiyya. You can't affirm for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala the opposite. So you can't say, for example, Allah is dead. The opposite for it is what? وَهُوَ الْمَوْتُ وَهَلُمَّ جَرَّ. And let the list go on. So this is good. And sifat al-fi'liyya, it is not connected to Allah's dhat. Rather, what it's connected to is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mashi'ah, Allah's will subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa ikhtiyarihi. So He does it whenever He wills subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the muta'allaq of both of them is different. Araftum? The muta'allaq of sifat al-dhatiyya is what? Allah's dhat. Sifat fi'liyya are connected to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's mashi'ah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But He gave an additional dhabt, is that the sifat fi'liyya, يُوصَفُ اللَّهُ بِمُقَابِلِهَا. The opposite you can affirm for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. For instance, صِفَةُ الرَّحْمَةِ, which is صِفَةُ فِعْلِيَةِ. Are you able to affirm for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala بِمُقَابِلِهَا, the opposite, وَهُوَ الْغَضَبُ, anger? نعم, you can. So this is لَا شَكَ وَلَا رَيْبُ, ضَبْطٌ حَسَن, a good observation from Ibn al-Hajj al-Maliki rahimahullah. نعم.
وأن جميعها تثبت لله من غير تمثيل ولا تعطيل, وأنها كلها قائمة بذاته وهو موصوف بها, وأنه تعالى لم يزل ولا يزال يقول ويفعل, وأنه فعال لما يريد.
The Sheikh rahimahullah, what he spoke about now is Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's characteristics are what? They are something that are present in Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are present in Him, whether it be connected to His that or whether it be connected to His mashi'ah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he mentioned a characteristics for as-sifat al-fi'liyya to clarify it more, which in its essence, as I said to you, is also sifat dhatiyya from another angle, which is what? وَأَنَّهُ تَعَالَى لَمْ يَزَلْ وَلَا يَزَالُ يَقُولُ وَيَفْعَلُ وَأَنَّهُ فَعَالُ لِمَا يُرِيدُ. Allah تبارك وتعالى is one who's mawsoofun, he's always, always described to be one who does. بِالْفِعْلِ. So Allah تبارك وتعالى, there's not a time when he doesn't do. سبحانه وتعالى. لذلك أهل السنة والجماعة, there's a matter which they speak about, and that this sheikh is going to go into it, which is قَدِيمُ النَّوْعِ حَادِثُ الْآحَادِ. قديم النوع حادث الآحاد. That's very powerful for you to memorize and for you to always know. What does it mean, قديم النوع حادث الآحاد? قديم النوع means that this characteristics in its essence, it is old. It was always present in Allah تبارك وتعالى. فكون الله متصف بصفة الكلام مثلا. For example, the characteristics of speech. Allah تبارك وتعالى being described as one who speaks, this, بهذا الاعتبار, this sifa is what? قديمة, is old in its essence. وَكَوْنُ اللَّهِ يَتَكَلَّمُ كَيْفَ شَاءَ مَتَى شَاءَ. And the fact that Allah تبارك وتعالى, he talks when he wants, to who he wants. For instance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he spoke to Nabiullah Musa. And Allah تبارك وتعالى spoke to Nabiullah Muhammad. And those two times are not the same time. So the scholars, they say, from that angle, it is haditha. It's new. So it is in its essence, قَدِيمُ النَّوْعِ حادث الأحادي. مثلا, a person is a writer and he knows how to write. Okay. ولله المثل الأعلى. But this is to make the matter clear for you. A person is a writer and he knows how to write, but he's not necessarily writing at that particular moment. Does that mean he's not a writer? No, it doesn't mean that. It means he's still a writer. But then when he starts writing, we'll say that his writing is what? قديم النوع. We'll say the writing for him is something that was there. Of course, it's not qadim in the essence where it's unrestrictedly old. Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, his one's always been there. As for the creation, there was a starting point. But this creation, you would say he was a writer. And then when he writes, you would say that this writing of his is something which he is doing different to the writing that he's done previously. His previous writing and the writing that he's doing now are both not the same. Then the Shaykh rahimahullah went on to say, Naam.
تَكَلَّمُ بِمَا شَاءَ إِذَا شَاءَ كَيْفَ شَاءَ لم يزل بالكلام موصوفا وبالرحمة والإحسان معروفا. ودخل في ذلك الإيمان بأن القرآن كلام الله منزل غير مخلوق منه بدأ.
The Sheikh rahimahullah, now he's speaking about what enters into الإيمان بالأسماء والصفات. We're still in الأسماء والصفات. From the things that enter it is what? الإيمان, to believe that Allah, that the Quran is the speech of Allah تبارك وتعالى. منزل غير مخلوق. That the Quran is sent by him سبحانه وتعالى. And that it's not created. منه بدأ. وهذه الكلمة, this word, تضبط بضبطين صحيحين. There are two ways of saying it. The first one is بدأ بالهمزة وهي من البداية. You can actually say بدأ, as I have just said, and it comes from the word بداية, which is beginning. You can also say, and that is بالهمزة. The second one is you can say it with an ألف, بدأ, and this دون همزة, which is not همزة. This means من البدو, which is يعني الظهور, to become apparent. So there are two ways of saying it. بدأ بالهمزة and بدأ بالألف. If you say it with the همزة, then it comes from البداية, beginning. And if you say it with an ألف, then it comes from بدو, which it means يعني الظهور, something to become a present. نعم.
وإليه يعود.
According to أهل السنة والجماعة, the meaning which is وإليه يعود, and that the Quran will go back to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, there are ثلاثة أقوال, three views or three speeches from أهل السنة والجماعة. And أقواها, the meaning that's the strongest, is أنه يرفع إلى الله, that the Quran will be lifted to Allah تبارك وتعالى من الصدور والسطور. من الصدور والسطور, that it will be lifted from the chests, and it would also be lifted from the scrolls and the papers that it's written on. That is the strongest of the three opinions أهل السنة والجماعة hold. And this is referring to في آخر الزمان, the latest sages, and not now. And ahadith have come regarding this. Some scholars have actually mentioned in Iqadul Ijma' that there's a consensus in this issue. From the scholars who've mentioned that is Al-Diya Al-Maqdisi rahimahullah. He has a kitab which he called Iqtisas Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem Bi'awdihi Ila Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Iqtisas Al-Qur'an Al-Kareem Bi'awdihi Ila Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. And the kitab is Matbu' Mutadawal. The book is actually published. And he speaks about this particular matter. And he brings Al-Athar and Ahadith supporting this from the people of knowledge. Na'am.
وَأَنَّهُ الْمُتَكَلِّمُ بِهِ حَقًّا وَأَنَّ كَلَامَهُ لَا يَنْفَدُ وَلَا يَبِيدُ.
The Shaykh rahimahullah now goes on to mentioning something very important, which is أَنَّهُ الْمُتَكَلِّمُ بِهِ حَقًّا. That Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is the one who speaks this haqqan truly. Why the Shaykh rahimahullah mentioned that Allah is the one who speaks it haqqan? Ya'ani, he means by it bihurufihi, the wordings, wa ma'anihi, and the meanings that are in it. لِأَنَّ أَهْلُ الْبِدَعِ وَالْأَهْوَاءِ. The people of innovation and desires, they affirm that the meanings is from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, but they don't want to affirm that the wording is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for Ahlul Sunnah, they say, إِنَّ الْمَعَانِ, the meaning, وَالْحُرُوفِ, and the wordings are مِنَ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. They are from Allah تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. That is why the author said, إِنَّهُ الْمُتَكَلِّمُ بِهِ حَقًّا. That Allah تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى is the one who truly speaks it. Allah is the one who truly speaks it. And within the Asha'ira, they differed amongst themselves. If the meaning is from Allah, then this wording of the Qur'an, which we have, who is it from? So some of them, they said it's from Jibreel. Even some of them said it's from the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. وهذا ضلالهم. And that's their misguidance and their deviation from the haq. نعم. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, بَلْ كَذَّبُوا بِالْحَقِّ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ. They disbelieved in the haq when it came to them. فَهُمْ فِي أَمْرٍ مَرِيجٍ. They are upon confusion and contradiction. نعم.
ودخل في ذلك الإيمان بأنه قريب مجيب وأنه مع ذلك علي أعلى وأنه لا منافة بين كمال علوه وكمال قربه.
The Shaykh رحمه الله, here he mentions دخل في ذلك الإيمان, from the things that enter believing in Allah's names and attributes is بأنه قريب, that Allah تبارك وتعالى is close, مجيب, one who accepts the supplication and the calling of his slaves. وَأَنَّهُ مَعَ ذَلِكَ عَلِيٌّ أَعْلَى. With Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala still being above his creation. So he's close to his creation. He accepts their supplication and their callings. But even then, he, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, is above his throne. وَأَنَّهُ لَا مُنَافَاتَ بَيْنَ كَمَالِ عُلُوِهِ وَكَمَالِ قُرْبِهِ. And that there is no contradictions between Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala being one who is above his throne, higher than his creation, and also he subhanahu wa ta'ala being close to his creation. There is no munafat. There's no contradiction between the two. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah Abu al-Abbas Ibn Taymiyyah al-Harrani, he mentions this in his kitab Al-Tadmuriyya and Al-Hamawiyya, and many places in his kitab, in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, rahimahullah. He says, rahimahullah, Aliyun fi dunuwihi qareebun fi uluwihi. That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is close. Uluwiyun fi dunuwihi. Allah is far, he's higher than his creation in being close to them. And qareebun, he is close to them. Fi uluwihi, in him being higher than them. So he's trying to prove that أنه لا منافات, that there is no contradictions بين كمال علوه وكمال قربه. But there is something that needs to be mentioned here, and it is of high importance, and that is أن القرب الإلهي, Allah being close to his creation, ليس متعلقه جميع الخلق, ليس متعلقه جميع الخلق, and that it's not connected to all the creation. For verily Allah تبارك وتعالى being close to the believers is of what? النصر والتأييد. Allah تبارك وتعالى is supporting the slaves, the believers, and he is aiding them subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for qurb, for the disbelievers, it doesn't exist. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala does not give them nasru wa ta'id. Because the meaning that says that the qurb is amun, it's general, li jami' al-makhluqin, such as al-ilm wal-ittila', that Allah has knowledge and is observing his creation, the believers and the disbelievers. That is the qurb, which is am, that meaning you won't find it in the Quran, nor would you find it in the sunnah. The meaning that you find in the sunnah, the Quran and the Sunnah, is qurbun khas, the specific type of closeness. And that is the one we mentioned, an-nasr wa-ta'yid, victory and support. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala mentions that in many places in the Quran. As for the one that's in the qawluhu ta'ala, وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ, that we are closer to them than the jugular vein. This qurb is meant by يعني الملائكة. It's meant by the angels that are closer to the individual than the jugular vein. It doesn't refer to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. نعم.
لأنه ليس كمثله شيء في جميع نعوته وصفاته ولا يتم توحيد الأسماء والصفات حتى يؤمن بكل ما جاء به الكتاب والسنة من الأسماء والصفات والأفعال وأحكامها على وجه يليق بعظمة الباري ويعلم أنه كما أنه لا يماثله أحد في ذاته فلا يماثله أحد في صفاته.
The Sheikh rahimahullah in the first part where he says ولا يتم توحيد الأسماء والصفات حتى يؤمن بكل ما جاء به الكتاب والسنة من الأسماء والصفات والأفعال وأحكامها على وجه يليق بعظمة الباري. This actually means that the person surrenders and he accepts that whichever he finds in the kitab or the sunnah that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala affirmed for himself, a name or a characteristics, then he affirms that name and he also affirms that characteristics. And wherever he finds in the sunnah that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala negates from him a characteristics, then we negate that characteristics from him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same is anything we find that the messenger alayhi salatu wa salam affirmed for Allah, we affirm for him. And anything which we find the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam negating from Allah, we negate from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's names and attributes, affirming it and negating it, are taken from the kitab and the sunnah. And the way we affirm those characteristics and the way we affirm those names is ala wajhin yaliqu bi'azamati al-bari, in a way that befits Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, his majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he also says la yumathilu ahadun fi dhati fala yumathilu ahadun fi sifati. Just like there's no one like Allah in his essence, then there is no one like Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in his characteristics. لأن the characteristics can only be resembled to the characteristics of the creation if the that of the creation is like the that of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And the that of Allah is not like the that of the creation. The same is the characteristics is not the same as the characteristics of the creation. Na'am.
وَمَنْ ظَنَّ أَنَّ فِي بَعْضِ الْعَقْلِيَاتِ مَا يُوجِبُ تَعْوِيلَ بَعْضِ الصِّفَاتِ عَلَى غَيْرِ مَعْنَاهَا الْمَعْرُوفِ
The Shaykh rahimahullah, he mentions here, anyone who assumes to himself, في بعض العقليات ما يوجب تأويل, as you find, some people what they do is, they come over a characteristics, and they distort the meaning that is in this characteristics. They negate it, thinking that they are purifying and exalting Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And so what they do is, they run to distortion as a result. And the reason why they think to them that is the case is because it logically and rationally goes against the mind. The Sheikh says anyone who does that, فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا مُبِينًا, then that person has become misguided, a clear-cut misguidance. Why? لِأَنَّ الْعَقْلَ الصَّحِيحِ, because the correct, straight, rational mind, the pure, clean, rational mind, لَا يُخَالِفُ النَّقْلَ الصَّرِيحِ, does not oppose the correct and direct text. The aql, which is as-sahih, the correct, the healthy, rational mind that's healthy, is that which is far from desires and that which is far from doubts. وَلِذَلِكَ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ, the people of knowledge, they say, إِنَّ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ, the prophets, لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمَحَالَاتِ الْعُقُولِ وَإِنَّمَا يَأْتُونَ بِمَحَارَاتِ الْعُقُولِ, that the prophets do not come with things that are rationally impossible. Rather, what they come with is that which is rationally amazing, fascinating. So prophets don't come with لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمَحَالَاتِ الْعُقُولِ وَإِنَّمَا يَأْتُونَ بِمَحَارَاتِ الْعُقُولِ, the things which we find that the prophets come with is مَا يُحَيِّرُ الْعُقُولَ, that which confuses the mind in amazement and shock. but not that which is rationally impossible. And if a person finds that something is rationally impossible, then it's either one of two. Either his aql is not sahih and he is affected in one way or another, or the text that you are actually looking at is not authentic from the Messenger alayhi salatu wassalam. So it is impossible that an aql sahih opposes a naql sarih. ولذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله, he wrote a book which he called it درء تعارض العقل والنقل رحمه الله, in which he refuted فخر الدين الرازي رحمه الله, and he refuted him when he tried to come with the concept of dealing with how the Quran and the rational mind should deal with one another. شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية wrote that the work which لا شك ولا ريب أسكتهم, it silenced them and it shocked them, رحمه الله رحمة واسعة. نعم.
ولا يتم توحيد الربوبية حتى يعتقد العبد أن أفعال العباد مخلوقة لله.
The Sheikh رحمه الله, he now moved on to a topic which is very well known as بمسألة أفعال العباد. This chapter or this point is known as the actions of the creation. And this topic is very large in its quantity. Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah have actually written books on it. From the most famous book is the book written by Al-Imam Al-Bukhari rahimahullah. He wrote the book Khalqu Af'al al-Ibad. Al-Imam Al-Bukhari rahimahullah. But the khulasa, the conclusion in which Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah mention is that إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ, the creation, his mashi'ah and his irada, his will is tabi'an li mashi'ati Allah. It is in accordance to the mashi'ah, the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa qudrati wa ikhtiyari. It is in accordance to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's will, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's ability, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's choice. So Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, they do not say in al-abda majburun ala fi'lihi, that the creation is forced in his actions and that he has no choice and that he's a leaf on a windy day. They don't believe that. But rather what they believe is he has a free will and he has a choice. That choice and that free will of his is in accordance to the choice and the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the khulasa, a summary of what Ahl al-Sunnati wal Jama'ah say. Naam.
وأن مشيئتهم تابعة لمشيئة الله وأن لهم أفعالا وإرادة تقع بها أفعالهم وهي متعلق الأمر والنهي وأنه لا يتنافى الأمران إثبات مشيئة الله العامة الشاملة للذوات والأفعال والصفات وإثبات قدرة العبد على أفعاله وأقواله.
Those two, they do not contradict one another. What doesn't contradict one another? That Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala's qudra and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala's ikhtiyar and mashi'ah, and the fact that the creation has a mashi'ah and an irada. They don't contradict each other. Naam.
وَلَا يَتِمُّ تَوْحِيدُ الْعِبَادَةِ حَتَّى يُخْلِصَ الْعَبْدُ لِلَّهِ تَعَالَى فِي إِرَادَتِهِ وَأَقْوَالِهِ وَأَفْعَالِهِ.
The Shaykh rahimahullah, he now speaks about Tawheedu al-Ibadah, what is known also as Tawheedu al-Uluhiyya. That the slave, his Tawheedu al-Uluhiyya will not be complete حَتَّى يُخْلِصَ الْعَبْدُ لِلَّهِ تَعَالَى, until he comes purely purely all his will, iradat, and his aqwal, and his af'al, his will, his speech, and his actions, all of them, he purely does it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولذلك العلامة ابن القيم رحمه الله, he says, إخلاصنا لله صف القلب من إرادة سواه فاحذر, فاحذر يا فطن. إخلاصنا لله صف القلب من إرادة سواه فاحذر, فاحذر يا فطن. And the haqiqah, the reality of al-ikhlas is mentioned in that line of poetry, which is tasfiyatul qalb, to purify your heart min iradati ghayrillah, wanting something from other than Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. You're not doing this for anyone else. You're truly and you're utterly doing it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Naam.
وَحَتَّى يَدَعَ الشِّرْكَ الْأَكْبَرِ والمنافي للتوحيد كل المنافة وهو أن يصرف نوعا من أنواع العبادة لغير الله تعالى وكمال ذلك أن يدع الشرك
أن يدع الشرك
وكمال ذلك أن يدع الشرك الأصغر وهو كل وسيلة قريبة يتوصل بها إلى الشرك الأكبر كالحلف بغير الله
كالحلف يمكن سيفي هي بغير الله
بغير الله ويسير الرياء ونحو ذلك.
The Sheikh rahimahullah, he now went towards the direction and speaking about that which a person needs to stay away from. Once he comes with التوحيد الألوهية, if you come with التوحيد الألوهية, there is something that can nullify your التوحيد الألوهية, and that is البراءة من الشرك الأكبر والشرك الأصغر. The شرك الأكبر, what it does is يناقض التوحيد, it will nullify your tawheed. As for shirk al-asghar, yanqus al-tawheed, it places deficiency in your tawheed, it reduces it. So shirk al-akbar yatatarraqu ila asl al-tawheed, shirk al-akbar what it goes towards is asl al-tawheed, the fundamental and foundation of your tawheed. So when a person comes with shirk al-akbar, then what happens is yazulu tawheeduhu bil kulliya, his tawheed will remove and it will go fully. But if a person comes with a shirk al-asghar, then the kamaluhu al-wajib will go. But that means the person is a mu'min, naqis al-iman, he's a believer and his iman is naqis. This taqseem of a shirk, because يقسم الشرك باعتبارات, shirk can be divided from many different angles, and this is just one angle of categorizing shirk. This taqseem, which is shirk al-akbar and shirk al-asghar, this maqala, this belief of shirk al-akbar and shirk al-asghar, is not a maqala wahhabiyya, as some people think, that Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah was the first one to come with it, wa ashabuhum, and his students and his grandchildren. And that's not the case, but rather this is present and it's found in the statement of the sahabas ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. Faqad rawa al-hakim fi mustadrakihi, al-imam Hakim narrated in his mustadrak bi sanadin sahihin, an authentic chain of narration from ash-shaddad ibn awsin radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, which he said kunna na'uddu ar-riya'a ala ahdi rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam min ash-shirk al-asghar, that we used to at the time of the messenger alayhi salatu wa salam, we used to categorize and consider الرياء, showing off, as to be from الشرك الأصغر, not to be from الشرك الأكبر. So the Sahabas رضي الله تعالى عنهم, they knew this categorization, that the shirk is of types, شرك الأكبر and شرك الأصغر, and that this is not something that was recently introduced either by Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab or Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah رحمه الله. That's not the case. But then when ignorance became present in the people and the knowledge of a tawheed has become little, then the people started to come with this thought and belief that it is something that Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah came with. Rather, if you look at the books of the A'immatu al-Ilm, such as Abi Yusuf al-Qadhi, who is Ahad Ashabi Abi Hanifata rahimahullah, you find that statements of his also show that. Al-Imam Abu Qasim Hibatullah al-Lalaka'iyu mentions it in his kitab Sharh Usul I'tiqadi Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'a. So the shirk is categorized into those two categorizations, Ash-shirkul Akbar and Ash-shirkul Al-Asghar. Na'am.
والناس في التوحيد على درجات متفاوتة بحسب ما قاموا به من معرفة الله والقيام بعبوديته فأكملهم في هذا الباب.
So the Sheikh رحمه الله, after speaking about الشرك, after mentioning what shirk is and giving it an explanation, the Shaykh Rahimahullah, what he did was when he defined shirk al-asghar, what did he say? هُوَ كُلُّ وَسِيلَةٍ قَرِيبَةٍ يُتَوَصَّلُ بِهَا إِلَى الشِّرْكِ الْأَكْبَرِ. It is every means that will reach you and get you closer to shirk al-akbar. That dabid and that definition from the Shaykh is not jami' mani'. It's not very comprehensive. The best definition is الشرك الأكبر هو جعل الشيء من حق الله لغيره مما يتعلق بأصل الإيمان. The shirk al-akbar is when you give a rights from the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to other than Him, that which would affect أصل الإيمان. Whereas shirk al-asghar is when you give a rights from the rights of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to somebody else, مما يتعلق بكمال الإيمان. But it's connected to the person's complete iman, not the asal of the person's al-iman. Where you would find, if you look at, for example, the book Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid, which is the first explanation that was ever placed on the kitab, Kitab al-Tawheed, للشيخ الإسلام محمد ابن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله. Ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab, rahimahullah, he didn't finish this book, Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid. And if he was to finish it, it would have been best. And it would have been the best book written and explained in Kitab al-Tawheed. But his cousin, Abdul Rahman ibn Hassan ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab, he came and he summarized the book, Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid, and he called it Fathul Majid. Fathul Majid. And so Fathul Majid is complete. So that's why the scholars, they give it preference over Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid. If you read that book, Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid, you will find that, and also if you look at the kitab, Al-Jawab al-Kafi, Liman Sa'ala Ali al-Dawa al-Shafi, which is also known as Al-Da' wal-Dawa, and the book, Madarij al-Salikin, written by Al-Allama Abi Abdullah Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, rahimahullah. What they said was that, rahimahullah, they made Al-Riya' showing off as to be also Shirk al-Akbar. But the reason why they made al-riya showing off as to be shirk al-akbar is because they looked at the person who's coming with it. If a munafiq comes with al-riya, then of course he is a kafir for it. And it just increases in his kufr. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَلَا يَأْتُونَ الصَّلَاةَ إِلَّا وَهُمْ كُسَالَى. They do not come to the prayer except that they are lazy and they do not stand for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Except little. So this is what Sulaiman ibn Abdullah and Ibn al-Qayyim meant by that showing off is considered as to be shirk al-akbar. But they meant by it بِالنَّظَرِ إِلَى فَاعِلِهِ, when you look at the person who's doing it, not looking at the riya itself. But the riya itself is shirk al-asghar, as Al-Imam Hakim mentions in his Mustadrak from Shaddad ibn Awsin radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Then the Shaykh rahimahullah, he mentions that annasu fi tawheed, that the people are in tawheed ala darajatin mutafawitatin, they are of different levels bihasabi ma qamu bihi min ma'rifatillah. Pay attention to this. The people's tawheed are of different levels. And why is that? Why are the people's tawheed of different levels? بِحَسَبِ مَقَامُ. The reason is because مِن مَعْرِفَةِ اللَّهِ, knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. That which has been in their hearts in knowing Allah. وَالْقِيَامُ بِعُبُودِيَتِهِ. So when a person learns Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and he comes to understand Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, then his understanding of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala increases. And his ubudiyya, servitude increases. ولذلك ابن القيم mentions هربوا من الرق الذي خلقوا له فبلوا برق النفس والشيطان. هربوا من الرق الذي خلقوا له فبلوا برق النفس والشيطان. They ran away from the servitude in which they were created, and they ran to servitude for their own nafs and shaytan. And those are the people whose understanding ma'rifatullah, the knowledge of Allah, and knowing who He is, subhanahu wa ta'ala, it decreased. And the reality of knowing Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is what increases in al-iqbalu turning towards Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, wal maylu ilayhi, and to divert to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more your knowledge increases, inshaAllah, the more your iqbalul qalb, your heart turning to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala increases, and the more you face towards him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then when the person's knowledge of Allah decreases, then what happens is their iqbal of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and their mail to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala also reduces. Naam.
من عرف من تفاصيل أسماء الله وصفاته وأفعاله وآلائه ومعانيها الثابتة في الكتاب والسنة وفهمها فهما صحيحا فامتلأ قلبه من معرفة الله وتعظيمه وإجلاله ومحبته والإنابة إليه وانجذاب جميع دواعي قلبه إلى الله تعالى متوجها إليه وحده لا شريك له ووقعت جميع حركاته وسكناته في كمال الإيمان والإخلاص التام الذي لا يشوبه شيء من الأغراض الفاسدة فاطمأن إلى الله تعالى معرفة وإنابة وفعلا وتركا وتكميلا لنفسه وتكميلا لغيره بالدعوة إلى هذا الأصل العظيم فنسأل الله من فضله وكرمه أن يتفضل علينا بذلك.
So the Sheikh rahimahullah, he mentions the person who has the completeness of Iman, فأكملهم في هذا الباب, the person who has the completeness of ubudiyyah, servitude, is man arafa min tafasil asma'illahi wa sifatihi wa af'alihi wa ala'ihi wa ma'aniha athabita fi al-kitab wa sunnah. It is the person who has knowledge of the details of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's names, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala his attributes, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's actions, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's blessings, wa ma'aniha thabita, and the meanings that are present in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's names, fil kitabi wa sunnah, wa fahimaha fahman sahihan, and the person understands it, a correct understanding. Famtala'a qalbuhu min ma'rifatillah, then what will happen? What will happen? Famtala'a qalbuhu, your heart will be complete, min ma'rifatillah, in knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. If you study al-asma'i wa-sifat in details, your knowledge of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is going to increase. Wa-ta'abimihi, you're going to honor Allah tabarak wa ta'ala properly. Wa-ijlalihi, wa-mahabbati, you're going to love him subhanahu wa ta'ala as he deserves to be loved. Wa-al-inabati ilayh, then you're always going to turn and run to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until the author said, fatma'anna ilallahi ma'rifatan wa-inabatan, he becomes tranquil. Tranquility he finds in himself, and he turns towards him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa fi'lan wa tarka, everything which he does is in accordance to what he commanded. Whatever he stays away from is what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told him to stay away from. Wa takmilan li nafsi wa takmilan li ghayrihi bi da'wati ila hadha al-asl al-azim, he completes not only himself, but he also completes those people who are around him by making sure that he establishes this benefit and this knowledge in which he has come to know to the people. So this is a person who Allah tabarak wa ta'ala had wanted good for them. So the Shaykh rahimahullah concluded this asal by saying, فَنَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ, we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, فَقَدَّمَ الْمَفْعُولَ عَلَى الْفَاعِلِ, the Shaykh put precedence over the maf'ul, over the fa'il. وَمَا قُدِّمَ حَقُّهُ أَن يُؤَخَّرَ, anything that is put forward when it deserves to be delayed, يُفِيدُ الْحَصْرَ, it shows exclusivity. So the Shaykh is trying to say that I do not ask, or we do not ask from anybody other than Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, min fadlihi, from his virtue, wa karamihi, and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala's karam, ay yatafaddal alayna bidhalika, that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he bestows upon us his virtue. Sorry, the Shaykh rahimahullah, he said, fanas'alullah, he put the maf'ul in his right place, he did not put it forward, na'am. But if he placed it forward, it would have been better. If he was to say, fallaha as'alu, ama fallahu nas'alu, for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala we ask, then that meaning would have been more stronger than if he was to bring, if he brought it the way he did right now. We will conclude there inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong, فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ بَرِئَانِ مِنُهُ سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ.